Hey guys, Natasha with the Day with Ethel vlog. So if you see my vlogs, I hope you all do, you would know that I'm a huge Alex Wolf and Sloane Howell fan. I love their cocky Playboy series. I love the Collins brothers. I love Covington. I just love the whole, this dynamic duo when they write, because they really could give you world-class dominant men, but then superior world-class dominant women don't put up with any of the men's bullshit. And that's what I really enjoy about the series. And I was so excited that I saw that they kind of wrote a Christmas romance. This is the Christmas Playboy, and this is Matthew and Karli's story. Karli Rains is an intern. She just got accepted to the internship program at the Hunter Group. And let's just say she literally plows in to a very gorgeous man. This guy at first is a world-class dick, but that's how he is. And you know, Karli's trying to get her bearings. She's just walking into the Hunter Group. Lo and behold, the world-class person she literally ran into is the lawyer that she's going to be paired up with. And they both kind of like look at each other like, oh no, this isn't going to work. But then there's the sparks are flying underneath it. And you kind of have to laugh, but what does the Collins brothers do? These Collins brothers, Dexter just knows to really know how to like throw you through a loop. And he ends up having to pair her with another lawyer. And so Matthew, what does he do? He's gonna step up his game. He's gonna get Karli's attention. And I kind of have to laugh because these two, Karli and Matthew, kind of have this funniness towards him. Like they have these weird one-off one lines, like puns or just humor to their relationship. And I enjoy it because you kind of have to laugh as you're reading. You're like, oh my gosh, did he just say that? Or did she just say that? And it's funny, like Matthew even says it. He goes, the perfect lines and symbolism represents of the Rococo period. And it's kind of just hilarious because they just kind of want these really one-offs, like, where did you read that? And that's what I enjoy about their series, is because they kind of throw some humor, some romance, and some very kind of dominant, hilarious times between these women and the men in their stories. But what it's also fun is that, yeah, it was extremely fast. These two kind of fell into bed, you know, in a passionate romance. But it's that connection, that feeling that, oh my gosh, you know, this person is really meant for me. And I think that, he even says it, in every other area of my life, I can control myself. When it comes to Karli, I don't think I can. And it's because when he's with Karli, he almost, not possessive, but he just feels like he's control of, you know, without her, he's control of his emotions, control of his job, control of like how he does his lawyering. But when Karli's in the room, it's like everything's up for grabs. Like she just is a magnet to everything about him. His, you know, emotions, his, just the way he talks. But Karli does it too. You know, she's also extremely, doesn't know how to think about him, but she's not afraid to call you out on your bullshit. And she kind of does when something happens, and she's ultimately kind of has to leave the Hunter Group. And I really do appreciate her boldness towards Tate. She's like, yeah, you can be nice to him all you want, Tate, but I don't really want you to be associated with me. And I like that she stuck to her guns. I like that she wasn't afraid to call you out on your BS. And that's what I love about how, you know, Sloane and Alex write, is they give their women really strong, independent voices. And that's what draws me to their writing. And then we get a glimpse of everybody from the Hunter Group. You know, we get Paisley's in there, we get Covington, and you know, we get the Collins brothers, but I need more Donovan. Again, I need more Donovan. But it's ultimately the humorous part is, you know, the Die Hard references. And if you think Die Hard is not a Christmas movie, skip over, please, right now. And what I enjoy that their Die Hard references are throughout this story. Because it's just how the story is. And it's, you know, that quick, fast pace, run at the gun, you know, quick-witted Matthew and Karli. And how it all comes together is exactly, you're everything. And that's how Matthew and Karli feel about each other. But guys, with this, it's humor, it's lust, and it's love. This is the Christmas Playboy. It's in the links right below. Click on it, go read it, then go watch the movie Die Hard, or go get all the rest of the Playboy books because by far, these Collins brothers, they're downright fun. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.